गुड डे फ्रेंड्स, लेट बिगिन आवर लेक्चर नंबर 7 ऑफ एटीपी सब्जेक्ट। दिस इज यूनिट नंबर 2। नाउ लेट सी एमएनई सिस्टम्स, दैट इज मैकेनिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टम्स फॉर ए ग्रीन हाउस बिल्डिंग। ओके, नाउ हियर ए सिंपल wind mill is there, wind driven ventilation, okay, that converts wind energy into mechanical energy and mechanical energy to electrical energy. Then rainwater, it is collected here in these devices, okay, and it is reused for water circulation, water use, okay, it is used for water harvesting and reuse technology. Then these are IT wired, then low flush WC, that is water closet, that is toilet that requires low flushing, some air system is given to flushing of the toilet. This is the septic tank, okay, in this septic tank that recycles the effluent, okay, the human waste, okay, and it is converted into some manure, okay, and that manure is fed to plants, okay. Now here wind is also circulated, other than energy producer, wind is circulated directly into the house, okay, through the ventilators, okay. So there are two purpose, one is windmill that converts wind energy to electrical energy, and also these are the air inlet into the house. Okay, now this geyser or heating devices, they are controlled by the solar systems, okay, then heating element, okay, it goes to hot water, goes to biofuel, okay, so this is the biofuel supplied, then this is electrical charge, okay, and biofuel is produced over here, okay, and it is then supplied to the house and kitchen system, okay. Then this is the polyvinyl to charge electric cars, okay, electricity is generated from the solar energy, okay, and it is used to charging the electric cars. Then again this rainwater is directly allowed to enter into the house through this piping system, okay, and it is stored in an underground storage system, okay. Now building physics, green buildings in summer produces cooling, in winter stores passive heat and gains until needed, okay. These are the various sections of greenhouses, okay. Air enters over here, okay, it circulates in the house and it exits here from the top. As the air gets heated, its density decreases and it rises up. So these are the systems in typical system in greenhouses. Okay, you can go through this. Now green pyramid rating system, that is Egypt in 2009, for site planning it has given 200 marks, for energy 325 marks, water 90 points, material and resources 65, indoor environment quality 150, pollution and waste management 140, and design innovation 90 points. Now green pyramid rating system, okay, this is green rating system, okay, with 1000 points, then gold rating system with 800 points, and silver rating system with 600 points. Results: energy, site, water, indoor environment for all systems. Pollution, transportation, emission management in some system. Emission, pollution, indoor environment, health in same meaning. Building type effect up effect rating scale. More points means more sustainable building. Climatic, economical and building types causes some changes in each rating system. Design phase is very important. Indian Green Building Council, that is IGBC. The Indian Green Building Council IGBC was formed in the year 2005 by Confederation of Indian Industry, that is CII. The aim of the council is to bring green building movement in India and facilitate India to become one of the global leaders in green building. IGBC rating system. IGBC has developed green building rating programs to cover commercial, residential, factory buildings, etc. Each rating system divided into different levels of certification are as follows: certified to recognize best practices, silver to recognize outstanding performance, gold to recognize national excellence, and platinum to recognize global leadership. Green building projects in India. Very few. Suzlon Energy Limited, Pune. Biodiversity Conservation India, Bangalore. Olympia Technology Park, Chennai. ITC Green Center, Gurgaon. The Drug White Lotus School, Ladakh. Dune School, Dehradun. Rain Tree Hotel, Chennai. Nokia, Gurgaon. Then Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, Hyderabad. Hiranandani BG House, Powai. ABN AMRO Bank, Chennai. Then Palais Royal at Worli, Mumbai. And Punjab Forest Complex, Mohali. Suzlon Energy Limited, Pune. So several accolades continue to shower upon Suzlon's global headquarters in Pune. One Earth. One Earth is the name of the building. LEED certified it as platinum and it is built on an area of 10.13 acres. One Earth can be counted as among the largest green projects in India. Green building projects in India. Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, Hyderabad. India's first greenfield airport, in undeniably among the top 10 green buildings in India. First airport in Asia to be certified with silver rating. The green building ensures optimal use of natural light and minimal wastage of electricity or energy consumption. The Nokia Gurgaon, that is gold rated building by LEED. Its smart lighting, heat recovery wheel and high efficiency chillers makes this office stand out from the rest. Different from other buildings, the design, maintenance and construction of buildings have tremendous effect on our environment and natural resources. Green building is different from the other building because it uses a minimum amount of non-renewable energy, produces minimal pollution, increases the comfort, health and safety of the people who work in them. It also minimizes the waste in construction by recovering materials and reusing or recycling them. Increasing green. Today more than 1053 green buildings are being constructed all over India, of which 147 green buildings are certified and fully functional. Benefits of green building. Buildings have a large effect on the environment, human health and the economy. The successful adoption of green building development can maximize both the economic and environmental performance of the building. Environmental benefits. This protect diversity and ecosystems, improves air quality and water quality, reduce waste streams and conserve natural resources. Economic benefits. Reduce operating cost, create, expand and shape markets for green products and services, improve occupants' productivity. Social benefits. Enhance occupants' comfort and health, heighten aesthetics, quality, minimize strain on local infrastructure, improve overall quality of life. This is a typical triangular float chart of green building. Okay, social, then environment and economics. These three attributes are achieved in a green building. देन अर्बन डिजाइन एंड रिन्यूअल, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक अर्बन डिजाइन एंड रिन्यूअल। डेफिनेशन, ए कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस ऑफ रीमॉडलिंग ओल्डर पार्ट्स ऑफ अर्बन एरियाज इंक्लूडिंग देयर सेंट्रल बिजनेस एरियाज बाय मीन्स ऑफ रिहेबिलिटेशन एंड कंजर्वेशन एज वेल एज रिडेवलपमेंट। द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ एन एग्जिस्टिंग लो इनकम पॉपुलेशन क्रिएटिंग स्पेस फॉर मोर प्रॉफिटेबल ऑफिस कमर्शियल एंड लग्जरी रेजिडेंशियल डेवलपमेंट और द प्रोविजन ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट फैसिलिटीज। अर्बन रिन्यूअल डेफिनेशन, लोकल पॉलिसीज एंड स्ट्रेटेजीज डिजाइन टू डील विद अर्बन डिक्लाइन डिके और ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन आर टर्म एज अर्बन रिन्यूअल। इट इज कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एंड इंटीग्रेटेड विजन एंड एक्शन विच लीड्स टू द रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ अर्बन प्रॉब्लम्स एंड विच सीक्स टू ब्रिंग अबाउट ए लास्टिंग इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द इकोनॉमिक फिजिकल सोशल एंड एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस ऑफ एन एरिया दैट हैज बीन सब्जेक्ट टू चेंज विद द डिसीजन एंड अथॉरिटी ऑफ ए गवर्निंग म्यूनसिपैलिटी rearranging land use function and ownership features of a socially economically or structurally decayed part of the certain city such as slum zones or brownfields for the purpose of obtaining a desired well organized neighborhood. Understanding urban renewal, the term urban renewal means rebirth or regeneration of a city or a part of it which has been plagued by the ills of urbanization. The planning concept originated in England and in America in the late 1930s. Decayed parts of the city were demolished and rebuilt. Initially referred to slum clearance and housing, but has gradually evolved into a multi-dimensional concept. These programs were thrust upon the city and its people and were criticized and halted on the opposition by organized community movement. Why urban renewal? The main triggers points are effective functioning of administrative town, that is state headquarters or district headquarters, to accommodate an event of magnitude, that is Asian Games, Commonwealth Games in Delhi, tricentenary celebrations of consecration of the Guru Granth Sahib at Nanded, the necessity due to natural or man-made calamity, that is earthquake in Bhuj, plague in Surat. Obsolescence of land uses, that is shifting of manufacturing industries, market-driven change of land use, commercialization of Girgaon poorer areas of Mumbai. Then to conserve historic monuments, environment, areas around the Taj Mahal, present lack of modern facilities. Where urban renewal is requested or is required? Urban renewal is required for dilapidated, aging parts of the city, not providing the city its full potential, and improvement of transportation network provision and improvement of utilities, becoming a health hazard. In built forms, it consists of an old area of the city, congested area around the transit point, illegal settlements needing redevelopment. In terms of infrastructure, measures for efficient and smooth movement of traffic. Basic concept. Urban renewal programs are generally undertaken by public authorities or by local government. The emphasis is on those parts which have fallen below current standards of public acceptability. These are commonly to be found in the residential parts of the inner city, the central business district itself. Indicators for residential parts of inner cities are inadequate housing, environmental degradation, presence of non-conforming uses. Indicators for central business district are traffic problems, congestion, dilapidated buildings. Dilapidated means deteriorated buildings. Tools and approaches. Slum clearance. Demolition of dilapidated built dwellings located in a slum. Redevelopment. The demolition of an existing building and replacement and its replacement by new building. Rehabilitation. The repair and improvement of existing structurally sound property, housing improvement of dwelling by providing of essential basic amenities, conservation to retain intact or unchanged, environmental improvements, main emphasis is on to improve environmental conditions, economic renewal, improvement of economic conditions of dwellers. urban renewal projects. Following projects fall under urban renewal: redevelopment projects, economic redevelopment strategies, housing loans and other financial pools, streetscape improvements, transportation enhancement, historic preservation projects, and parks and open spaces. This flowchart of urban renewal process, survey of the area, then issue of identification, knowledge of act and DCR, that is development control room, then UDPFI guidelines, urban development prohibition and federation India guideline, provisional of urban renewable benefits, drives urban productivity, example creating mixed use development project based in CBD, creating regional hubs just outside of city limits to reduce residential and commercial pressures on inner city areas, creates employment opportunities, attracts increased investment, intensifying use of land, densification of area can create new markets for business, enhance housing affordability, brings key workers closer proximity to employment opportunities, capitalized on existing infrastructure, improvement of existing infrastructure saves cost of new expensive infrastructure, increased tourism revenue and improved infrastructure and services. Indian context. Urban renewal in Indian context. Indian cities have a history that dates back to centuries. In the last century, cities faced a major unprecedented forces of urbanization which ripped them. They have grown exponentially. Their administration has not been able to cope up with rapid urbanization. The age-old infrastructure is weakened and decayed, leading to degeneration of the core areas in the city. Cities which have survived centuries are now at critical stage. Concept of urban renewal to provide life to the dying cities. Kevin Lynch technique, the image of the city. This book is about the look of cities and whether this book is of any importance and whether it has can be changed. The book looks at three American cities, Boston, Jersey City, and Los Angeles. Kevin Lynch found that there are five basic elements which people use to construct their mental image of a city: pathways, district, edges, landmarks, and nodes. Nodes means squares. Paths are the channels along which observer moves. They may be street, walkways, transit lines, canals, or railroads. Kevin Lynch in the image of the city. Now edges. Edges are the linear elements not used as path by the observer. They are the boundaries and linear breaks in continuity. Shores, railroads, cuts edges of development and walls. Kevin Lynch, the image of the city. District are the medium to large sections of the city which the observer mentally enters inside of and which are recognizable as having some common identifying character. Kevin Lynch, the image of the city. Nodes are the points, the strategic spots in a city into which an observer can enter and which are the intensive focal or foci to and from which he is traveling. They may be primarily junctions or concentrations. Landmarks. Landmarks are another types of point references, but in this case, the observer does not enter within them. They are external. They are usually a rather simple defined physical objects, that is building signs, store or mountain. Now spatial organization, creating through landform, built environment and trees, creation of quality of space, put more attention on spatial pattern, distribution of land use and resources. Land use zoning is the regulation by law, different types of zones like residential or commercial, etc. Proper allocation of each type of zone by spatial organization leads to effective planning. Urban transportation, one is roadway, vehicular or pedestrian, second one is railway, third one is airway, fourth one is waterway. Now urban housing, there are various categories of urban housing. economically weaker section, that is EWS, lower income group, that is LIG, medium income group, that is MIG, and higher income group or high income group, that is HIG. Thank you very much.